Welcome back! Oh, let us continue, shall we? Yes, but it's just as weak as usual. Yes, I know people, it's hard to believe that Marcus will become the weakest character late game. Well, that's because... Well... Oh, that's it. It's just how it is. A farmer will get to be stronger than a old onion rust ruined all his life. During the course of the game, that is. Looks like I'm almost finished with this chapter. So, I wonder if it was necessary to be splitting it. Could be that I'm just going to put these episodes together. What is it? Sorry, having some booze can't remember my lines correctly. What is this, a pack of children going to play? You think you can challenge me? What? For a night? But that's impossible! Other characters may need the experience. Yes, I should have known that bears are not good against axes. But still. It'd be pretty awkward if Eliwood died right there. Very awkward. Was thoroughly touring around. Well, you were very unlucky. Lord Eliwood, yes? Our dearest Huntsfolk come to the aid of our fair village. Think nothing of it. It's a Lord duty to protect the citizenry. Well, that were true, my lord. The good folk of Lahus know not such protection. Their Marquess, Lord Darin, is too busy preparing for war. They ignore all complaints of bandits and thieves. Preparing for war? Are you sure? I would not lie, my lord. My brother lived in Lahus until a few days ago. His home was tortured, had no choice but to flee here. According to him, Lahus could go to war any day now. It's all the people of Lahus are talking about. Lord Eliwood, if this is true, I'm so sorry for this. The situation is a grave one. If Marquess Lahus is ready for war, his target is most likely another Lysian territory. Perhaps this is connected to Lord Albert's disappearance. My father and Marquess Lahus? It seems that Heno's connection, but it's as good a start as any. Let us travel to Lahus, we must learn more. Thank you for your guidance, Luca. What are you bound for next? If you have no destination in mind, perhaps you can travel with us. Ours is a small group. With a single purpose, to find my father. I do not know where our run will lead, but we won't be stronger with you in our company. Of course I will help. You will travel with us? Splendid! Thank you! I pray we give you a wonk. I mean, let me rephrase that, sorry. Pray we give you no cause to regret your decision. Rupi! Rebecca! Where do you think you're going, young lady?
Father, I intend to accompany Lord Eliwood.
Don't be ridiculous, girl! Lord Eliwood is not going on a picnic. He's riding into danger.
I know that, Father. That's why I want to go. We owe him our lives and I want to repay him. My bow may not be all that much, but I know I can be of service. But... And Father, I may meet up with my brother somewhere. You're the magistrate, your responsibilities. This is all I can offer. I need to do this. Please, Father, let me go.
Dear me, that is as stubborn as your mother was.
I'm sorry, Father.
You must bow to Lord Eliwood's wishes on this matter. If he consents, you may go.
Thank you, Father.
Lord Elber has always been kind to us. Follow his holy flat, true heart, Rebecca. Serve Lord Eliwood well, as I have served his father.
I will, Father.
Well, I thought wrong about the length of this episode. Well, seems like I don't need to merge these episodes. So, until next time, see ya!